You sure Crocker hasn't called? He was supposed to meet me here half an hour ago.
Another drink while you're waiting, Mr. Whitney?
Sorry, Fred. Seven's my limit.
You sure?
All right, make it a double, huh?
I hear you're up to England, Mr. Whitney.
Oh, big stuff, Fred. The biggest.
Business, huh?
Henley Regatta. Boot the Yale boat home. Bulldog, bulldog, bow, wow, wow. Eli Yale!
Live on!
Crocker, you're half an hour late. Where the hell have you been?
Relax, boss. I've been taking care of business. I got your steamer ticket.
Good, 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 good.
English money.
Good.
Train ticket up to Henley.
Mm-hmm.
And I picked up your dog at J Press. Your sweater looks terrific.
Yes, it does. What about my passport?
Aw, oh, nuts! I'm sorry, boss. I'll pick it up first thing in the morning. Bring it to you on the boat.
Damn it, Crocker. I wanted you down on Wall Street first thing in the morning to sell all my shares of Amalgamated Prestolium.
But, boss, the firm's entire assets are tied up in Amalgamated.
Oh, I got a hot tip from Charlie Blodgett. Amalgamated is gonna sink like the Titanic.
Wait a minute. You told me Charlie Blodgett was a liar and a drunk.
He is, but he's a Yale man.
One for the road, sir?
Oh, yeah, make it the usual, huh? Good night, gentlemen.
Anybody call for me, Fred?
Harriet, Nancy, Lorraine, two Lorraines, actually.
How about a Hope? Hope Harcourt?
Nope, but a woman came and asked him for you.
No, he's wrong, Billy. It was only me.
Reno. Oh, my God, we had a date.
It's okay, Billy. I'd say forget it, but you already did.
Listen, my boss is going to London in the morning. I had to do 1,000 things for him.
Billy, I'm going to London in the morning, and all that you had to do for me was buy me one lousy drink.
What'll it be, ma'am?
A martini. Only make it rye and put a cherry in it instead of an olive.
Two Manhattans, Fred.
You know, Billy, I'm getting worried about you. I don't think this Wall Street job is good for you.
Hey, I'm making $35 a week.
Yeah, but look at you. Look at your coat, Billy.
What's wrong with my coat?
It's got a fried egg on the pocket.
Hey, that's an old school crest.
From where? PS 88? Listen, kid, you're in trouble, and if you don't stop acting like a stuffed shirt stockbroker, you're going to turn into one.
Why do I put up with this, Fred?
Because you're nuts about me. In fact, Billy, I've got a great idea. Why don't you come to London with me?
Reno.
Come on, Billy, we'll do the town upright. Buckingham Palace, the bushes in Hyde Park, Big Ben.
Reno, be serious.
I am being serious, Billy. London won't be the same without you.
Reno, guys like me are a dime a dozen. You won't miss me over there.
Why are the cute ones always so dumb? My story is much too sad to be told, but practically everything leaves me totally cold. The only exception I know is a case when I'm out on a quiet spree, fighting vainly the old ennui, and I suddenly turn and see your fabulous face. I get no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some get a kick from cocaine. I'm sure that if I took even one snip, that would bore me terrifically too. Yet I get a kick out of you. I get a kick every time I see you standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's clear to me you obviously don't adore me. I get no kick in a plane. Flying too high with some guy in the sky is my idea of nothing to do. Yet I get a kick.
Something I want to tell you.
Yeah?
I'm in love.
I'm in cabin number 13. Come on.
I know. Come on. Not with you. Reno, I'm in love with a girl. She's fantastic. She's so fantastic, she won't even talk to me. That's why I can't go to London in the morning. I've got to stay here until...
Oh, so that's it, huh, Billy? All this time you've just been giving me the runaround.
The runaround?
Billy, you had me thinking you wanted to marry me.
How could you think that? I always treated you with respect.
Exactly. Did you ever try to get me drunk?
Well, there's
no! No. Did you ever invite me up to your apartment to look at your etchings?
Well,
No. Billy, we have been in taxis dozens of times. And did you ever try to grope me? No. Not one lousy grope. You shouldn't have led me on like that if you didn't mean it.
Reno, I never meant to mislead you.
Like hell you didn't. You never even laid a hand on me. I'm not used to men treating me like that.
Reno.
My dear, sailing off without me, yet you don't seem to give a damn.
I know it's fearful of me not to be more tearful, but thank heaven I am. Now don't be funny, I'm just wild about you, honey, but I'm oh so glad it's driving me mad to say goodbye to all things that typify the humdrum of my daily routine.
And there's no cure like travel to help you unravel the worries of living today. When the poor brain is racking, there's nothing packing a suitcase and sailing away. Take a run round Vienna, Granada, Havana, Siena, and then a round round. Have a high time, a long time, and in no time you'll be singing home, sweet home.
Mr. Eli, wait. Whitney come aboard?
Well, Mr. Whitney's in the bar.
I thought you kept the bar closed until you sailed.
Yes, but he had a note from his doctor.
Captain, Captain! Right. I can task you to make sailing. What is it?
Icebergs? Hurry.
Works. Callie Chapman's is wired. She's canceling his birthday thing on the Mauritania.
Oh. Good God. Pass him to the swift. Hope Harcourt, the deputy. It's not bad.
The Normandy has Jimmy Walker and Machine Gun Kelly.
Lord Evelyn Oak.
Nothing. What the Englishman?
Wait a minute. Looky here. Benjamin Frank.
Captain, it's not the same one.
Oh. Then we've got nobody. Quick, run down to the store club and see if they got anyone left over from last night.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Hey, Captain. Captain, where's all the celebrities?
This tub is better than the Flying Dutchman. Oh,
fellas, fellas, please.
Ah, the gentlemen of the press. Allow me to introduce myself. Reverend Henry T. Dobbs.
Not me. Henry T. Dobbs.
Oh, give it up. As you've no doubt heard, I'm on my way to the Westminster Conference, where I shall present my two newest converts, Luke and John. Luke here was a compulsive gambler. As a reminder of his former shame, he carries a deck of cards. John was a compulsive drinker.
Reno Sweeney!
All right, now we're getting somewhere. Hey, Reno, what are you doing aboard this barge?
Same thing I do in my nightclub, boys. Saving sinners twice a night in the ship's lounge.
I see you've brought the sinners with you.
Boys, meet my angels. Purity.
Hi, boys.
Chastity.
Hello, boys.
Charity.
Hi, boys. And I'm Virtue.
Hi.
The easy kind, no doubt.
Say, brother, was that a pass?
Miss Sweeney, I have no interest in either you or your fallen angels. I'm ashamed to be seen in public with you.
Say, boys, how about a picture, girls?
No, no, what? No, no, get, no, no.
Make sure you send a few to the Archbishop. Come now, who will lead this sinner beside distilled waters?
What?
Which way to the bar?
Oh, over there.
Thank you, girls.
Hey, girls, give us the hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
Hey, look, Pope Harcourt.
Hey, Miss Harcourt,
are you presiding at the Gold and Silver Ballotier?
How about the Newport Cotillion?
Gentlemen, gentlemen, please. My daughter's debutante days are over. She is about to be married.
Married?
It's true. I'm marrying Lord Evelyn Oakley. We're to be married aboard ship, and I'm very, very happy.
Hey, Evie, how about a smooch?
I beg your pardon.
It's a kiss, Your Highness.
No. How marvelous. You know, I'm making a collection of the expressions you Americans use. A smooch is a kiss. No, 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 no. I say, darling, how about a smooch? Mwah. Smashing.
Gad! Evangeline Harcourt.
Elijah Whitney.
Down, boy, down.
Eli, you haven't changed in 40 years.
Me? Take a look at you. You always did know how to fill a girdle, huh?
Eli, really? You might have some respect for the memory of my late husband.
Oh, yes, of course. Well, if it's any consolation to you, I was just coming out of the stock exchange when he took off from that ledge. He jumped like a true Yale man.
Thank you, Eli. Oh, my God. You know my daughter, Hope.
Oh, yeah.
And this is her fiancé, Lord Evelyn Oakley.
Her fiancé?
That's a foreign word, Crocker. That means they're getting married.
I don't believe it.
I still don't either. And yet, in 3 days, my little Hope will be a lady.
Oh, sensational. Well, let's all have a drink, huh? Come on, everybody, down to the bar.
Smashing.
Isn't Mr. Crocker going to join us?
Crocker? No, 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 no. Crocker's got a date down on Wall Street, don't you, buddy? Come on, sell those shares. All right.
Good ship.
Hope. Wait.
All ashore, it's going ashore. All ashore, it's going ashore.
7 o'clock, you'll do your morning prayers. 8 o'clock, you'll do your catechisms. And at 9 o'clock, you'll do my shirts.
Yes, yes, ma'am. You,
minister?
A what?
FBI. I'm looking for a gangster dressed up as a minister. Have you seen him?
He went that way.
Show me.
I've got to see someone in the bar.
Show me.
But listen, I don't have time for this.
Are we in England yet?
No, we ain't. And where's Snake Eyes? He still hasn't shown yet.
To hell with Snake Eyes. He's public enemy number one. He can take care of himself.
You don't suppose the cops snapped him, do ya? Oh my God, I gotta find him.
Would you keep it down? We're trying to make a getaway here.
Snake Eyes! I'll
see you! Hey! Shh! Whoops, my Stradivarius.
Ah!
Whoa!
Allow me to introduce myself, Doctor. The Reverend Henry T. Dobson. Are you on your way to the conference?
Actually, I thought I'd go to bed early tonight.
No, you see, I mean the Westminster Conference.
No, you see, I'm not a Westminster. I'm really more in the East.
Ah, what is your field, Doctor?
Well, I'm a sort of a kind of a missionary.
Missionary? Where?
Way out in China.
China.
Way out in China.
I've served in China for years.
Well, I wasn't exactly in China, you see. I was more...
Oh, I see. You must have been in Indochina.
That's it. I was in indoor China, and you were in...
Outdoor China. We'll have plenty to talk about. Hanishiwa.
I don't know, but I think it's downstairs.
There it is. FBI. Got to move.
Look, I've got three words of advice for you, son. Get off the boat.
I can't fight Snake Eyes.
No.
What have I done? My man is my
wife.
Forget
about Snake Eyes.
Okay.
Final call. All the shorts going ashore.
Could you let me have them?
And exactly who are you?
Give him the goods. He saved my ass.
All right.
Murray Hill Flowers. Murray Hill Flowers? Where'd you get a name like that?
The Yellow Pages.
Final call. All the shorts going ashore. Final call.
What am I doing? I'm supposed to be down on Wall Street. Excuse me, purser. I'm looking for Miss Hope Harcourt. Is she in the dining room?
She and Lord Oakley have been out for the 8 o'clock seating. Mr.,
Cleaners. Murray Hill Cleaners.
Murray Hill Cleaners.
I mean flowers. Oh,
what
nuts.
What is her name, sir?
Billy Crocker!
Hi, Billy.
Billy, you came after all. I didn't see you come aboard. Where have you been hiding? Billy, how did you get a ticket? Oh, I see. You're still sore at me for last night. Listen, Billy, I... So, you're not still sore at me for last night. Hell, you should be, Billy. I was way out of line.
Reno, forget it.
No, Billy, I've been thinking about it, and if you want to settle for second best and go after Miss Fantastic, go right ahead.
I did. She's on the boat.
Fantastic.
Reno, I'm in a mess. My boss is going to lose his shirt. I'm going to lose my job, and all because of some damned dame.
She must be some damned dame.
Oh, she is. You're going to love her. Her name's Hope. Hope Harcourt.
Hope Harcourt? The debutante Hope Harcourt? The Hope Harcourt who got out of a Zeppelin? The Hope Harcourt who chases foxes on the cover of Life magazine?
What are you saying? She's out of my league?
Billy!
Maybe you're right.
Billy!
No. I can see it now. Guys like me deliver her groceries. They don't walk her down the aisle. Besides, she's engaged to some English guy, an Earl or something.
Billy, where's the old Crocker confidence? Do you think some teabag can compete with you? Do you think he's got one tiny fraction of your brains? Your looks? Your... At words poetic, I'm so pathetic that I always have found it best, instead of getting them off my chest, to let them rest unexpressed. I hate parading my serenading, as I'd probably miss the bar. But if this ditty is not too pretty, at least it'll tell you how great you are. You're the top. You're the Colosseum. You're the top. You're the Louvre Museum. You're a melody from a symphony by Strauss. You're a Bendel bonnet, a Shakespeare sonnet. You're Mickey Mouse. You're the Nile. You're the Tower of Pisa. You're the smile on the Mona Lisa. I'm a worthless check, a total wreck, a flop. But if baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top.
Your words poetic are not pathetic. On the other hand, babe, you shine. And I can feel after every line a thrill divine down my spine. Now gifted humans like Vincent Humans might think that your song is bad, but I got a notion, I'll second the motion, and this is what I'm going to add. You're the top. You're Mahatma Gandhi. You're the top. You're Napoleon Brandy. You're the purple light of a summer night in Spain. You're the National Gallery or Garbo's salary or cellophane. You're sublime. You're a turkey dinner. You're the time of the Derby winner. I'm a toy balloon that's fated soon to pop. But if baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top. What do you mean?
You're the top. You're an arrow collar. You're the top. You're a Coolidge dollar. You're the nimble tread of the feet of Fred Astaire. You're an O'Neill drama.
You're Whistler's mama.
You're Cabman Bear.
You're a rose. You're Inferno's Dante.
You're the nose on the Greek Durante. I'm just in the way, as the French would say, to drop. But if baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top.
You're a dancing volley. You're the top. You're a hot tamale. You're an angel, you simply choo-choo-choo to be. You're the Botticelli, you're Keats.
You're Shelley.
You're Ovaltine. You're a boon. You're the dam at Boulder. You're the moon over Mae West's shoulder. I'm a nominee of the GOP.
Or Gap!
But if baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top.
You're the top. You're one of seven.
boats that glide on the sleepy Zuider Zee. You're an old Dutch master.
You're Lady Astor.
You're Berkeley. You're romance. You're the steps of Russia. You're the pants, yeah, on a Roxy Usher. I'm a broken doll, a falter, alt, a bop.
But if baby, I'm the bottle. You're the top.
Breaths, dear. That always helps me.
Sure, darling.
Come on now. Oh, maybe you should go lie down.
And leave you alone now, Wouldn't dream of it, dear. Besides, I'll be right as rain as soon as we escape these swells.
But the sea's as flat as a pancake, dear.
Please, Hope. I wish you wouldn't mention food just now.
I'm sorry. I'll go get you a bromo.
Thank you, darling.
Hi, Hope.
Hi, Billy. Billy!
You know, you're beautiful when you're about to faint.
I didn't know you were sailing.
Me neither.
Then what are you doing here?
I'm selling lifeboats. I stowed away to be with you, Hope. I just couldn't let you go.
Oh, Billy. You know my fiancé, Lord Evelyn Oakley.
Billy Crocker. Pleased to meet you.
I'm afraid I rather overdid it in the dining room.
Me too. Did you have the sweetbread? Best brains I ever had.
Billy.
I've never quite seen them served that way. With jellied eels and head cheese.
Billy, stop it.
Nigel!
Billy, was that fair?
Fair? I find you standing here in the moonlight with him. I didn't shoot him. I didn't push him overboard. I thought it was more than fair.
You're being terribly bad, Billy. Why, we hardly even know each other.
Hardly know each other?
We met one night at a party. We danced. We had a little too much wine. We took a little spin around the park.
You call 5 hours in the back of a taxi a little spin?
4 hours.
Five. Remember? You fell asleep after
I remember. Thanks.
Then, I took you to that little cafe down by the docks.
We had breakfast as the sun came up.
We talked about moving to California, buying a bungalow. Raising orange trees.
Raising kids. Oh, but Billy, that was a fantasy. Things like that just aren't done.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Me and you. Who am I kidding? I know too well that I'm just wasting precious time in thinking such a thing could be, that you could ever care for me. I'm sure you hate to hear that I adore you, dear, but grant me just the same. I'm not entirely to blame for you. So easy to love, so easy to idolize, all others above. So sweet to waken with, so nice to sit down to eggs and bacon with. We'd be so grand at the game, so carefree together, that it does seem a shame that you can't see your future with me. 'Cause you'd be oh so easy to love. So easy
to love, so easy to idolize all others above, so worth the yearning for, so swell to keep every home fire burning for. Oh, how we'd bloom, how we'd thrive in a cottage for two, or even three, four, or five. So try to see your future with me, 'cause you'd be oh so easy to love.
This is all wrong. I'm marrying Evelyn. Nothing can change that.
You can change that. All you've got to do is say...
No. Now, if you don't leave me alone, I'll make a scene.
You love me, Hope. You're gonna marry me.
Crew, mama, that's the thing I want to do, mama, to be known throughout Yale as I walk about it, get a boil on my tail and then talk about it. Yes, operator, give me stage room 1616, Miss Evangeline Harcourt. Thank you. Yes, Evangeline, it's Eli. Eli Whitney, listen, I just had a swell idea. I'm all alone down here, and you're all alone up there. At least I hope you are. What? Well, who cares what time it is, my turtle dove? I think of you, and time stands still. Your face alone would stop a clock. Hello? Hello? Must be on her way up. I'd like to be a big bloke, mama, and learn that new Argentine stroke, mama. You'll see your slim son putting crimps in the crimson when I row on the varsity crew.
Where do you think you're going, Toots?
I'm going to the boy. Oh.
You're not going anywhere. You're a big mouth, you can land us both in Sing Sing. Sit down, we're gonna play us some cards.
I don't want to play cards.
I said sit down, sweetheart.
Got any fours?
Go fish. Who is it?
It's me, Billy.
Oh, hang on, I'm saying my prayers. Amen. Come in, my son. Pull up a pew.
Thanks, Doc. I gotta stay low for a while. I don't think the purser believes I'm Murray Hill Flowers.
I could kill the other guy.
I don't think a doc could help me. The girl I'm in love with is gonna get married.
Yeah, and I could kill the other guy.
You could kill the other guy?
That's right, I could. But I bet he couldn't see you if I swiped his glasses.
That's right, his boss is in the other room. We heard him sticking.
If he finds out I'm on the ship, I'm dead.
Don't worry, we will take care of this right now.
That's him.
Just a moment, my pet. The game's afoot.
Come in, my dear.
Oh, my dear. You look ravishing.
I thought I needed a shave myself.
What the hell? Padre, what the hell are you doing here?
I just come around to take up the collection.
Don't you do that in the chapel?
You planning to attend chapel?
Well, no.
Then pony up, or I'll come back in the morning when you've got a hangover. That's funny. I seem to be wearing someone else's hat. Can you read the initials in here?
Where are my glasses?
You sure you had them on when you barged in here?
What? But this is my stateroom.
What am I doing in here? I've never been so insulted in my life. Why don't you put on your other pair of glasses?
That was my only pair.
Good. That's what I wanted to know. Well, I stole his glasses. We'll be all right as long as the captain doesn't show up.
Who is it? Yeah. Oh, we gotta fight. Oh, it's not you. Oh. Just a minute, Captain.
Come in.
Sorry to disturb you, Doctor, but does a Mr. Murray Hillflowers occupy this cabin?
Not very often. Is anything wrong?
Well, you see, we received a radiogram from Washington. The man you're traveling with is not Murray Hillflowers. He's Snake Eyes Johnson, public enemy number one.
Public enemy number one? Santo Domingo!
Well, Doctor, don't worry about it, Doctor. My men can handle him. And if he does turn up,
me if I'm out of line, but I don't think you're really a minister.
Kid, I'm not a minister. I'm Moonface Martin, the famous gangster.
Yeah, public enemy number 13.
Help, please. Hey, you're not gonna turn me in, are you?
Relax, Doc. We're pals.
Good. Then where are you going?
I've got a wedding to bust up.
You can't go out there. The captain thinks you're Snake Eyes Johnson.
Right. What I need is a disguise.
Yeah. A gorilla suit, or a set of armor.
Or a sailor suit.
Oh, do you need a sailor suit? No problem.
Oh, sailor's life is supposed to be a hell of a lot of fun. Yes, but when you're a sailor, take it from me, you work like a son of a gun. I give them jobs of every kind and chores of every sort. But sweat away, sailor, you don't mind, 'cause you know when we reach port, there will always be a lady fair, a Jenny fair, or a Sadie fair. There'll always be a lady fair who's waiting there for you. There will always be a lady fair to smooth your troubles and to muss your hair. There'll always be a lady fair who's waiting there for you. There will always be a girl's caress to change your answer from a no to yes. There'll always be a lady fair who's waiting there for you.
Now, Sailor, keep this quiet.
Ridiculous! His pants must be 6 inches too small.
I don't think you're gonna pick the guy for the length of his pants.
Oh!
Don't show them coming out! Dirty deck. Clean the dirty deck.
What was that noise, sir?
Crap shooting contest.
Crap shooting contest?
Skeet shooting, sir. First prize is $100.
Can you use your own gun?
Of course.
See you later.
Wait a minute.
Paul! Yes!
Really, Mother, we didn't lose all our money in the crash. Well, if I decided right now not to marry Evelyn, we'd be fine.
We would not. You two haven't quarreled, have you? Oh, dear.
No, Mother, I'm marrying him. Everything will be all right.
Oh, good.
Paul! Yes! Paul! Yes! Paul!
Excuse me, ma'am. Are you Mrs. Evangeline Harcourt?
Why, yes.
Oh, no.
The captain has asked me to find you. The ship has hit an iceberg.
Oh, my God!
Shh! All the lifeboats are leaking except one. He's saving the last two places for you and your daughter.
Billy, this isn't fair.
Who cares if it's fair, Hope? The ship is sinking! Do I have time to go back for my jewelry?
Hurry, and remember, not a word to anybody.
I hope you're proud of yourself, Billy.
Well, now that you mention it, I am. 12 hours after you tell me to leave you alone forever, I've got you all to myself.
Not all quite to yourself. Good morning, Mr. Whitney.
Oh, morning, dear. I'm looking for a sailor.
Oh! Take a good look at this one.
Yes, I want to send a wire. This goes to William Crocker, Whitney Building, New York City. Dear Crocker, wire confirmation of amalgamated sales at once. You got that?
Better have him read it back to you, Mr. Whitney.
Read it back.
Dear Crocker, wire confirmation of amalgamated sales at once.
You know, you remind me of someone.
Look out!
What was that?
Biggest seagull I ever saw.
Gotta run. I'll see you later.
For shame. Go hail a few Marys, will ya? So, you've been playing cards. Do you know how to shoot craps?
No.
Then kneel, Christian, and watch closely. I put up my money. You put up your money. I throw a number. If I throw the same number twice before I throw a 7, then I win. If not, you win.
Box cards. Craps.
Thank you.
There's something wrong here.
Hey, thanks a lot.
Oh, don't mention it. What'd I do?
You walked out of me. I nearly got nailed by my boss, and everybody's laughing at me in this stupid disguise.
Hey, don't knock the disguise. Hell, it's practically as good as mine.
Hi, Billy. How you doing?
Mm-hmm.
And Moonface Martin, long time no see!
Shh, you don't know me, Reno. I'm a hunted man.
There he is!
Don't shoot! I'm... flying fish! I see flying fish!
Have you seen Mr. Flowers?
As a matter of fact, I just saw him going into the mizzen mast.
We don't have a mizzen mast.
Then it must have been someone else.
Sailor, come with me and watch how we find someone.
Aye, aye, sir.
Hey, Moon, who's he looking for?
He's looking for Billy.
Billy ought to be a big help to him, then.
What ho! It's Reno Sweeney!
I say, Lord Evelyn Oakley, might I have your autograph?
Sure, why not?
Do you know, I spent the most smashing evening at your club. Lordy, lordy, Saint Preservus! Your singing stirred me to a frenzy. Had me dancing about like bow jingles or something.
Thank you.
Are you drunk or crazy? Good luck, Reno Swing. I say, why don't we all come back to tea in my cabin? You know, my fiancé, Miss Harcourt, would simply love to meet you.
Oh, that's very sweet. I just don't think that I'd be able to.
She'd love to.
Marvelous. Shall we say 4 o'clock then?
Four o'clock.
Neaters. See you later, elevator.
Moon, that's the Tommy that's making time with Billy's girl.
Exactly.
No, isn't this going to be kind of like consorting with the enemy?
Yes, here's the plan. You get to his cabin early wearing something that slips off easy. Then I bust him and catch him tearing your clothes off. Then we blackmail him into breaking the whole engagement.
Moon, that's despicable!
You don't like it?
No, I love it.
You know, Reno, me and you, we should have teamed up years ago.
We're two of a kind, all right.
Partners.
Through thick and thin.
Night or day.
Right or wrong?
If you're ever in a jam, here I am.
If you ever need a pal, I'm your gal.
If you ever feel so happy you land in jail, I'm your bail.
It's friendship, just a perfect friendship. When other friendships are bit for fun, highs and will still be hot. A la da 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 dig dig dig.
If you're ever down a well, ring my bell.
If you ever catch on fire, send a wire.
If you ever lose your teeth when you're out to dine, borrow mine.
It's friendship, just a perfect friendship. When other friendships have ceased to gel, eyes and will still be sweat. A la da 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 da, hip hip hip.
If they ever black your eyes, put me wise.
If they ever cook your goose, turn me loose.
If they ever put a bullet through your brain, I'll complain.
It's friendship, just a perfect friendship. When other friendships go up in smoke, eyes will still be yoke. La da 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 do do do.
If you ever lose your mind, I'll be kind.
If you ever lose your shirt, I'll be hurt.
If you're ever in a manly get sawed in half, I won't laugh.
It's friendship, just a perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forgate, odds you will still be great.
If they ever crack your spine, drop the line.
If they ever cut your throat, write a note.
If they ever make a cannibal stew of you, invite me too.
It's friendship, just a perfect friendship. When other friendships are up the creek, ours will still be slick. A la da 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 da,
quack quack quack.
Quack quack quack.
Quack quack quack.
What do you think, I'm a duck or something? I'm not saying duck. Quack quack quack. I'm not saying it.
When other friendships have been forgot.
You Yanks are fast. Just put it there on the bed, will you? I'm glad it got here before I started to dress. I sure hope it's good and hot.
Nobody's complained yet.
Oh, my Lord. Dear me, I thought it was the man with my tea.
What were you going to do if it was cold? Cut off his head?
You mean Excalibur. Old family heirloom. Mother Harcourt wants me to wear it for the wedding. You know, it's odd. It seems the old bees is as taken with things English as I am with things American.
Well, I certainly am glad to hear you say that, because this American certainly feels gaga over you.
Gaga? I'm not sure I follow.
Does this make it any clearer?
Marvelous! To feel gaga about a person means to rub his neck.
No, Evie, you don't understand. You do things to me.
Do things to you?
Evie, you send me.
Send you where?
Evie, one look at you and I get hot pants.
Dear me, would a bit of ice do any good?
Evie, you don't understand. Hot pants means that I'm crazy about you.
Hot pants means you're crazy about me? Smashing, because I think you're the rat pyjamas. The absolute knees knees. I say, if something's funny.
Yeah, but it's also kind of cute.
Oh. Aha!
So this is what I find. You beast. You're the spoiler of innocent girlhood. Look at this poor child standing there, her clothes torn off by your fiendish attack.
Moon, hold
There's
on
There's something
a second.
Wrong here.
There's nothing wrong here.
Nope, stand back. I'll not permit this British line to twist American womanhood by the tail any longer. Do you think your girlfriend will marry you after this? I don't think she won't know, because I'm going to tell her.
Oh, do. Only make it a bit thicker. Hope does complain I lack fervor.
Now, you're not taking the right attitude, Buster Brown. I'm a dangerous man.
Go on, Padre. You're an old sweetheart, and you know it.
Okay, I'm going to prove to you I'm a desperate character. Do you have 1 minute? You wait 1 minute? I'll be right back.
I've noticed that sometimes these clergymen go a bit off.
Evie, there's something I've got to tell you. This was a setup.
A setup?
We were going to frame you.
Frame me?
Moon was supposed to walk in and catch us in a clinch.
I say, do you mean to say that he thought that I would make love to you?
That was the idea.
Oh, that is exciting. You mean you and me were going to...
You see? Now I guess you realize how serious this is.
Hold on a second, Moon. Put that thing down.
No.
Moon, put it down.
Oh, it's all right, Padre. You see, you thought that I was trying to take advantage of Miss Sweeney here, and you came to her rescue. And I admire you for it. In fact, I admire you enormously. What's the expression you Americans always use? I've got hot pants for you.
You came away from me, I'll shout.
Evening, folks.
Evening,
Francine. I trust you're all enjoying the crossing.
This is the dullest passing I've ever seen.
Well, you see.
Nobody's on this ship.
But
no celebrities. I want celebrities.
Yeah.
How about Gertrude Ederle?
The channel swimmer? Is she on board?
Well, you see, not exactly, but look, there she goes.
It must be her mother. She's the one behind all this.
I could kill the mother.
Move.
Okay, I got another plan.
Better be better than the last one.
Sailor! Sailor!
Yes, Captain! Yes.
Have you signed that criminal yet?
Not yet, sir.
Well, apprehend that man immediately.
Yes, sir.
And if you see any celebrities, better apprehend them too.
Aye, aye, sir.
Did you hear that? I've got to do something about this disguise.
Stay out of the kitchen or I'll put you on the menu. Sailor, find out who this belongs to.
Aye, aye, sir. If only I had a phony mustache.
Yeah.
Cheeky! Cheeky! Where is that dog?
Oh, now, they always find their way home.
His home is in Oyster Bay, Long Island.
Oh, be calm, my dear. Oh, you're like a trembling fawn. Here. Have a snort.
I told you, Eli, liquor has never touched my lips.
You know a shortcut?
Jimmy!
Oh, just look at that moon, Evangeline. Ah, yes. The night was made for romance, my sweet. Will you marry me?
I can't, sir. I'm already married.
What?
But there's a lady around the corner looking for a dog. Why don't you try her?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Quick, get rid of him!
What is it this time, madam?
I can't find my little Cheeky. Oh,
why, it's right beside your little Nosy.
How could you do that?
Relax, dogs are good swimmers.
Excuse me, ma'am. We are looking for our Lord Evelyn Oakley. Do you know him?
I should say so. He's going to be marrying my daughter. Is something wrong?
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Lord Evelyn Oakley. The man you thought was Lord Evelyn Oakley is in reality my brother, Edna.
Your brother, Edna?
Uh-huh. His real name is Mona, but he changed it. He's deranged.
Several months ago, he escaped from our family suite at Bedlam.
You have a family suite at Bedlam?
Uh-huh. I was taking him down to Seville Row for a new straitjacket when he gave me the slip.
Who's this man?
He's my brother's keeper.
Dear me, this is most upsetting.
Don't worry, we know how to handle him.
We've been through it a million times.
Uh-huh. You mean this has happened before?
Yes, he marries them, he murders them, he marries them, he murders them.
He murders their mothers.
But he seems so normal.
Aha! Uh-huh. She doesn't know the signs.
The telltale signs.
The fatal signs.
What signs? What signs?
There's a certain phrase he utters.
Just before he snaps.
Have you ever heard him say...
Water!
That's it.
Echo!
I say, how do you like it? Dear me, is she all right?
Yeah, relax. She's fine. She's just playing dead. Sit up. Roll over.
Wake up, Mom.
What do we do?
About 5 years with time off and good behavior.
Oh, my God. Mother! Mother! Billy, what have you done?
Listen, Hope, I can explain
everything.
You know
what, Billy? I don't want to hear it. His name isn't Billy, dear. It's Evelyn. And Evelyn isn't really Evelyn. He's Edna.
What?
Edna's really Mona.
I'll show you who he is.
Oh, I'm so sorry. It just slipped right out of my hand.
Dear.
Evelyn, why don't you take Mrs. Hartford to her cabin while I clean this little mess up.
Right here.
Dear me, but how else could go wrong?
There, there, Mom. Cheer up. Woof, woof.
How long are you going to keep up this stupid act?
I beg your pardon?
You're in love with him. Why don't you just admit it?
I don't think this is any of your
business. He may want you now, but he's not going to stick around forever. Half the women in New York City are crazy about him. Why, just the other day, one of the best-looking dames that I know practically proposed to him.
She did? Who?
Me.
Murmuring low. Let yourself go, so please be sweet, my chickadee. And when I kiss you, just say to me, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's delectable, it's delirious, it's dilemma, it's the limit, it's deluxe, it's the lovely.
I feel a sudden urge to sing the kind of ditty that invokes the spring.
I'll control my desire to curse while you crucify the verse.
This verse I've started seems to me the chimpantithesis of melody.
So spare us all the pain, just skip the darn thing and sing the refrain.
Me, 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 re, 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 do, so, mi, do, la, si. The night is young, the skies are clear, and if you want to go walking, dear, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. I understand the reason why you're sentimental, cause so am I. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. You can tell at a glance what a swell night this is for romance. You can hear dear Mother Nature murmuring low.
Let yourself go. And when I kiss you, just say to me, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's... myself.
Of course, I'll have to find out what the groom wants.
Of course.
Cognac? Cointreau? Whatever makes you happy, Mom.
Mom?
Billy, stop it.
All right. All kidding aside, Hope has a little announcement she'd like to make. You're on, kid.
Hope, what is this all about?
Go on. Tell her, baby. The world won't end.
I can't.
All right. I'll tell her.
No.
Listen, I know it's hard, but you've got to choose.
I say. Anyone have hot pants for a game of shuffleboard?
Captain, it's him!
What?
We found him, ladies and gentlemen. No cause for alarm.
What did he do?
Ladies and gentlemen, the man we've just arrested is Snake Eyes Johnson, public enemy number one.
Ooh.
Take him away.
Aww.
You idiot! Release that man. I thought you wanted to Captain Irons.
Clapton Irons, a celebrity like Snake Eyes Johnson?
Wait a minute. Let me get this straight. If I'm just a stowaway, you throw me in jail. But if I'm a famous murderer, you roll out the red carpet?
Well, you'll be my guest for dinner at the captain's table.
You know,
He's not the only gangster on this ship.
What do you mean, Doctor?
I mean, I'm not a minister. I'm Moonface Martin. I'm a public enemy, too.
Public enemy number two?
Yeah. Shut up, Irma.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it appears that we have not one, but two famous criminals on board. Let's make them both feel at home.
Looks like me.
There's room for one more.
What fun! Go on, darling.
Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the honorary captain of the SS America.
Times have changed, and we've often rewound the clock since the Puritans got a shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to stem, instead of landing on Plymouth Rock would land on them. In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. Good authors too, who once knew better words, now only use four-letter words. Writing prose, anything goes. The world has gone mad today, and good's bad today, and black's white today, and day's night today. When most guys today, the women cries today, are just silly gigolos. So though I'm not a great romancer, I know that I'm bound to answer. Getting matey with gigolos, anything goes. When mothers pack and leave poor fathers because they decide they'd rather be tennis pros, anything goes. If driving fast cars you like, if faux bars you like, if old hymns you like, if bare limbs you like, if Mae West you like or me undressed you like, why nobody will oppose. When every night the set that's smartest, intruding in nudist parties in studios, anything goes.
like, if old chairs you like, if back stairs you like, if love affairs you like, with young jazz you like, when no cutting up holes.
Tonight there's going to be some fun.
Sopranos, sopranos.
For Public Enemy Number One.
Public Enemy Number One.
Our gallant captain has told the staff.
The staff, oh, the staff, oh.
It's time for killing the fatty calf as he's throwing a party on behalf of Public Enemy Number One.
Public Enemy Number One.
American pirates both will be crowded on every run. To me, Public Enemy Number One.
Back to cheat and steal and kill, and you wonder if it's worth it, and then something like this happens. You guys are beautiful.
Come on, girls, we've got a show to do.
Okey-dokey, we know.
So, how do you like the royal treatment, snake eyes?
Nice.
Come on, Billy, I just saw Hope, and she's all broken up.
Oh.
Oh, a tough guy. What would you do if I told you Hope said that she wanted to marry you?
You're kidding. She said that?
No. Come on, you know she's in love with you and wants to marry you. She just doesn't have the guts to say so.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Sweeney's service is about to begin. Last call for drinks before the service.
Showtime, Toots.
I would appreciate it if you cease addressing me as Toots and henceforth call me by my right name, Mrs. Moon Face Martin.
Let me guess, you perform the ceremony yourself?
It is illegal, is it?
What is the matter with my waist? I'm a lonely man, Evangeline. Hey, Irma.
Hey, Irma.
Man, you look like a million.
I'm touched, really.
happen?
Don't be silly, darling. Come on, we have things to do, people to see. Look, it's Snake Ears!
Even no!
I say, Mr. Johnson, who am I? You dirty rat. You dirty, dirty rat.
Noel Coward?
Damn!
Even stop it.
You want to make her happy, pal? Do an imitation of me.
You know, Billy, sometimes you can be very cruel.
That's how we got to be number one.
SS American proudly presents the world's most sensuous sermonizer, Her High Stepping Holiness, Miss Reno Sweeney!
Hush. Brothers and sisters, we are here tonight to fight the devil, and there's only one way to fight the devil, and that's out in the open! You to turn to your neighbor and say, bless you, brother, bless you, sister.
Bless you, brother. Bless you, sister.
There's only one way to send the devil a packing, and that's to confess your sins. Come now, who will be the first to confess their sins and say, I am a sinner.
I am a sinner.
Hallelujah. Thank you, sister. Who's next?
I am a sinner.
Hallelujah. Who's next? Speak up, brother. I want to hear this.
Well, some time ago when I was visiting China, I met this little girl named Plum Blossom, of whom I became extremely fond. Eventually, we had a little unpremeditated romp in the rice, and I enjoyed it very much.
Thank you, brother. I was worried about you, but I feel much better now.
Hallelujah!
Do you hear that playing?
Yes, I hear that playing.
Do you know who's playing?
Who is that playing?
Why, it's Gabriel saying, will you be ready to go when I blow my horn? So blow, Gabriel, blow. Come on and blow, Gabriel, blow. I've been a sinner, I've been a scamp, but now I'm willing to trim my left. So blow, Gabriel, blow. So blow, Gabriel, blow. Once I was headed for hell. Once I was headed for hell. But when I got to Satan's door, I heard him blowing on his horn once more. So I said, Satan, farewell. And I've purged my soul and my heart too, to climb up the mountaintop and start to blow.
Blow, Gabriel,
come on and blow, Gabriel, blow.
Gabriel.
I want to join your happy band. I'll play all day in the promised land. So blow, Gabriel, blow. Come on, you scamps, get up, you sinners. You're all too full of expensive dinners. Stand up on your lazy feet and
I was low, Gabriel, low.
bone on his horn. So I said, Satan, farewell. And I've purged my soul and my heart too, to climb up the mountaintop and start to glow. Come on and blow, Gabriel, blow. I want to join their heavy band. I'll play all day in the promised land. So blow, Gabriel.
I'll give you a confession. 3 weeks ago, I met a girl and fell in love with her. How did I show it? I hounded her. I embarrassed her. I made her cry. I'm sorry, Hope. I just want you to be happy. I'll never bother you again.
What is this? He doesn't sound like Snake Eyes Johnson.
I'm not. I'm not a gangster. I'm a broken down broker.
Carson, clap that man in irons.
Get behind me, kid. We'll shoot our way out. There's definitely something wrong.
Get him,
there.
Get him!
Take a card, any card. All right, I'll take one for you. Now look at it. All right, I'll look at it for you. Now don't tell me which one it is.
Moon, I don't want to play cards.
What do you want to do, shoot craps?
I was thinking about shooting myself.
Kid, I know shooting yourself sometimes seems like a good idea, but believe me, it never works out.
Oh, yeah? Give me one good reason why I should live.
Cherry cheesecake.
A week ago, I was getting fitted for my first Brooks Brothers suit. Now look at where I am.
This place ain't so bad. We ever in jail in Cicero? I don't mean the new jail, I mean the old one.
Moon, my girl's getting married in the morning. I'll never see her again.
You know your problem, kid? You ain't got no philosophy. Life has taught me to think positive. It's like Dillinger once told me. Remember, it's always the darkest just before they turn on the lights.
There's an old Australian bush song that Melba used to sing. A song that always cheered me when I was blue. Even Melba said this bush song was a hell of a song to sing. So be quiet, we'll surrender it for you. When your instinct tells you that disaster is approaching you faster and faster, then be like the bluebird and sing tweet, tweet, tra-la, la-la, la-la. When you know you're headed for the jailer, don't a lousy old face to look paler, but be like the bluebird and sing tweet, tweet, tra-la, la-la, la-la. Be like the bluebird who never is blue, for he knows from his upbringings what singing can do. And though by other birdies in the boughs he may be told that his efforts are perfectly lousy, he sees on and on till his troubles are through. Tweet, tweet, tra-la, la-la, la-la.
What's going on up there? Have you seen Hope?
Yeah, and let me tell you, kiddo, you're well rid of that drip. I mean, all she does is whine and cry and stand around looking like Gabo and Camille.
Oh, did she say anything about me?
Why, no, she didn't, but, she sent you this note. Oh, and hey, how about giving me your passports? I mean, let's face it, you're not gonna need them where you're going, and I could sell them for a bundle, you know?
Good idea, Irma. Come here.
Oh.
Dearest darling, I love you so, but what good is love when there is no hope? Love, hope.
All through the night I delight in your love. All through the night you're so close to me. Shadows fall, but then once again will I know I was wrong. Being close to you all through the night.
Through the night I delight in your love.
staying close to you all through the
night by Lord Evelyn.
So I can do this.
A lonely figure walks the deck, the moonlight glancing off his beano. Tis not the ship, tis he the wreck. His heart dashed on a girl named Miss Sweeney. I say, you startled me.
Sorry, Evie, I couldn't sleep.
Nor I.
You know, Evie, the Lord works in mysterious ways. He's even got me stymied this time. My two best friends are in the slam, and tomorrow... Well, you already know all that. Here's to the happy groom.
I say, may I have a sip?
Make that here's to the groom.
Thank you, sir. Miss Sweeney, you see before you a man staggered by a revelation. It hit me like a stone hammer in the middle of your service. You see, the woman I'm destined to marry tomorrow was not one and the same with the woman I love.
You mean you're not in love with Hope? Gee, that's great! I mean, gee, too bad, but it's a good thing you found out.
Ah, there's the rub. Do you know the Oakley family motto, Nostrum Fugilium Centaurum?
What does that mean?
No one really knows, actually. But I'm pretty sure that I'm not supposed to go around backing out of engagements. At any rate, farewell, Miss Sweeney.
Evie, there's just one thing I don't understand. That whole thing about you and Plum Blossom and the rice paddy... How does that fit in with Nostrum Fugilium whatever?
Goodness, this is most embarrassing. Must I explain?
It's your motto.
Well, Miss Sweeney, I'm about to tell you something I've never told anyone before. It's the Oakley family secret. There's something dark and savage in our blood. In mine especially. Long, long ago, so long ago, I hardly knew when. My great-great-grandmother now and then stepped out with a gypsy. Of course you will say she was a little bit tipsy. But tipsy, no, no, of their love there wasn't a doubt. So I can't wait to get the stage all set so I can let... the gypsy in me out. Hiding away, there's a little bit of gypsy in me that's never been found. Waiting its day, there's a little bit of gypsy in me just hanging around. Till the magical night, when the stars by their light give mystery to the sleeping lagoon. While the haunting guitar, not too near, not too far, gaily strums away, hums away a tintillating tune. When I'm there in that dream, with the one in the world I worship passionately. At the moment supreme will be shown the unknown gypsy in me.
Thank you.
Hey, what's going on?
It's only been there for an hour. They cleaned out third class playing craps, and some folks are pretty hot about it.
What about us? When are we getting out?
I knew this would happen. I hope you are satisfied.
You know your problem, kid? You ain't got no philosophy. There's an old
Australian... Will you cut it out? What time is it?
1:30.
1:30 what?
I don't know. I lost a little hand.
The wedding starts at 9. We've got to get out of here.
Hey, you bums!
Reno!
Boys, I've got fabulous news. The best thing that could happen to a person just happened to me.
You got paroled.
Oh, she's in love.
Yep, and what's better than that? Evelyn's in love with me, too.
That's great. In fact, it's perfect.
Yeah, yeah. You marry Evelyn, Billy marries Hope. That only leaves one problem.
What's that?
How shall I put it? Let me out! Let me out!
Reno, we've got to think of something.
Yeah, if only we were Chinese.
Chinese?
Yeah, they're getting out in an hour. Say, old buddies. How about a little game of poker?
Yes, yes. He can't play cards. The puzzle took his money.
That's okay. We'll play strip poker. If I lose, I take off all my clothes. If you lose...
Pastor!
Oh, excuse me. Your shoe's untied.
Oh, thank you.
Your deal.
Okay, Billy, you're high. What do you bet?
I bet my coat.
Do you bet coat?
I bet my coat.
Do you stay coat?
I stay coat.
Fabulous. I stay coat. We all stay coat. You're high. What do you bet?
I bet my pants.
Do you call pants?
I call pants.
You call pants?
I call pants.
Call it all pants. Call pants.
We do!
Yeah? Buddy, beware. Buddy, better take care. Apart, I'm a pearl. I'm a difficult girl. So, buddy, beware. When I go to a show, luxuries are my necessities. So, buddy, beware. Ooh. Ready, boys? Lovely set! Ooh. And another thing too.
all your mail. Somebody beware. Well, fellas, what do you say now?
Well.
I thought.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today over the bodies of... Oh, dear me, I'm sorry. Well, here we go. We are assembled here today to join in the bonds of holy matrimony. These young...
Stop!
Good God, what is this?
We travel far. Come long way to talk to English gentlemen. We arrive in nick of time.
Oh, yes.
I'm afraid if you've come in reference to my Hong Kong interest, you've come at a rather bad moment. I'm about to be married.
No can marry.
Oh, no, no can marry.
Why no can marry? Why can't he be married?
Listen, I explain. I have honor to introduce Wu Chung Wu.
Oh, yes, that is me.
Father of Little Plum Blossom.
And who is Little Plum Blossom?
Yes, who is Little Plum Blossom?
This is Little Plum Blossom.
Oh, yes.
Little Chinese princess, until Lord Evelyn turned her into Little Chinese tramp.
Sure, I follow this.
Lord Evelyn take Plum Blossom into rice paddy. She come out Plum Tart.
Evelyn, is this really true?
I'm afraid so. East is east and all that, but I'm forced to admit that for one brief moment our twains did meet.
And how? Pretty soon, along come Little Plum Pudding!
Oh, yes.
Is this woman really Plum Blossom?
I don't know. It happened so long ago.
Long ago, so long ago.
Good Lord! Apologies to one and all, but I'm afraid that under the given circumstances, I could not possibly marry Miss Harcourt. Terribly sorry. Terribly sorry.
Now, let's not be ridiculous, huh? Like, all these people want is money!
Oh, yes.
82. I'll give you, say, $1,000 to clear out, huh?
Oh, we'll take it.
Do not insult us with our filthy money.
All right. $2,000.
Rich man cannot buy Chinese honor.
Okay, I'll make it $5,000.
Chinese honor sold.
No, Mr. Whitney, don't pay him. No amount of money can settle this great wrong. You, sir, are you relative of Little Plum Blossom?
The old poker buddies.
Then the only way to pay this debt of honor, Evelyn, is for you to offer him me.
I say, what a marvelous idea!
Oh, no!
Offer accepted! Chinese honor saved!
Oh, what about the $5,000?
Congratulations, old boy! You're getting yourself quite a girl!
Why not, English gentlemen, join club and right wrong done to poor Plum Blossom?
Right wrong done, poor. You confound it, you're right. See here, Plum Blossom, will you marry me?
Sweetie, I thought you'd never ask!
Darling!
Oh, Mother, what's the matter?
What's the matter? I'm poor again. I shall have to spend the rest of my life living in hotels.
Oh, like hell you will. Marry me, Evangeline. Say yes, and spend the rest of your days in the lap of luxury. Why, after this amalgamated deal, I'm so damn rich I could buy this tub. Turn it into a private yacht for you.
You're my savior, my knight in shining armor.
Mr. Whitney?
Crocker?
Yes, sir.
You never told me you were Chinese.
Oh. I'm not. I've got another confession to make. I never made it down to the stock exchange. I stored away on the ship, and I never sold those amalgamated shares.
That
means I'm ruined.
I'm sorry, boss.
Well, at least I have someone to comfort me in my time of misfortune.
Well?
Mr. Whitney!
Yes, sir.
Urgent cable from New York. Amalgamated went through the roof. You're a zillionaire!
How do you do it, boss?
How? I'll tell you how. Brains, guts, and the world's finest education. Bulldog, bulldog, bow, wow, wow.
Eli Yale.
Speaking of dogs, does this belong to anyone?
Cheeky, where have you been?
We found him in the swimming pool.
What was he doing in the swimming pool?
The dog battle.
All right, Captain, let's get on with it. You've got some weddings to perform here.
Come on, Cap, I've been waiting my whole life to be a lady.
Yeah, and step in it.
I get no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you?
Took even one sniff, that would bore me terrifically too.
Yet I get a kick out of you. I get a kick every time I see you standing there before me.
I get a kick, though it's clear to see you obviously don't adore me.
Get no kick in a play.